bushcrafting. Little bit of a north wind this morning. One duck egg. Thank you.
this little bag of potato chips was $2.91.
I really do not know what's going to become of our country at this rate.
Of course, I did buy it at a convenience store. But at those prices, I think that I'll just start bringing out these gallon freezer bags and buy a big bag. Alright, here in a few minutes we'll have some coals and I'll put this on the cook. Got to be sure you crush them chips up good and mix that egg in there good. It makes a delicious breakfast. Thank you.
That is delicious. If you've never tried it, it makes a great breakfast. And as I say, this was a duck egg. My wife raises ducks and chickens, and duck eggs are my favorite.
Dear Heavenly Father, I thank you for this opportunity to come out into the woods and just enjoy creation, Lord, your creation. Father God, I pray that you bless this food for the nourishment of my body. It's in your holy, precious Son's name, Jesus, that I pray this prayer. Amen.
Crush the chips up, mix it up good, place it in that pan of boiling water. I like to boil it a little bit, then remove the bag, kind of work the chips around, kind of flip it over, put it back in the water, boil it a little longer to be sure I get an even cook. It's delicious, as I say, no cleanup. And I received this tip from Blackie Thomas on his YouTube channel, and I have used it ever since. It is a great way to make breakfast. Little hassle. Now, if you excuse me, I'm going to enjoy my breakfast.
Dishes are done.
Well, this is a Wandering Graybeard. I'm going to finish this cup of coffee and head back to town. I was going to hang out here today, but it's just so doggone windy. And so I'll just go to town and maybe shoot a video of all the gear I carry in my bag like Ray did. That was a good video, Ray. Nothing beats Cowboy Coffee. Well, I hope everyone has a blessed week. I know I will. And those of you that are going to be in the path of the eclipse, it's awesome. But as for me, I'm going to enjoy what I can see of it, and I'm not going to worry about the world coming to an end. My Lord and Savior, when He calls my name, that's when my world will come to an end. Till then, I'm going to do the best I can. Well, welcome to another edition of Fireside Chat with the Wandering Graybeard. Today we're going to discuss a book that I'm currently reading, The Sun is a Compass. This is an awesome book. It's about a couple that goes through Canada up through Alaska, some of it by boat, some of it by raft, some of it by hiking, 4,000 miles. To the Arctic. This is an awesome book, and when this girl describes some of the plights and hardships they endure,
especially the mosquitoes. I even itch while I'm reading about the mosquitoes she talks about. So it's very good. So let's live vicariously through other people's adventures until we get to do our own. You can get this book on Amazon. By the way, this young lady and her husband live in Haines, Alaska. And I'm going to get to see Haines, Alaska in about 50 more days. Talking about adventures. Well, this is Wandering Graybeard thanking you for joining me on this fireside chat. Now for some cowboy coffee. Please join me. Bottoms up. Good coffee. If you get a chance, get out into the woods. It's good for the body, and it's good for the soul. And this peace and quiet, it's good for your mind. Adios.